Now again, this I've already touched upon, the world today and how it is throwing so much of negative information at us. We're talking about America going bankrupt. Then we are talking about Japan, we've already seen, has been ridden with natural disasters all the time. Tsunamis and earthquakes are rampant. Europe is also in debts. Then we have terrorism is on the rise. Global unemployment. When we're talking about mental health, the surveys have come out in the newspapers very recently. The WHO surveys, if you're reading the newspapers. Are you all reading and with me? With what I'm saying? Yeah, the WHO survey, the latest one, which one am I talking about? Which is under debate. Let's see who's reading and with me with what I'm saying. There's a mental health survey conducted by WHO, which is being talked about in the newspapers, and it has made some findings which are being debated by an Indian agency. Anybody knows the answer to that? Yes, that's right. Did you all read that? Okay. It's supposed to be a global survey, and I don't know, for whatever reasons, even when I read Indians particularly being used, I was also surprised. And today when I read in the newspaper, it's saying that the Bangalore-based mental health institution called NIMHANS has contested the WHO findings. So while what I'm saying is mental health years ago has predicted that depression is going to be number two disease in the world by 2020 on a global scale. The number one is heart disease and number two is going to be depression because the incidence of depression is just on the rise. Sorry? You're saying it's going to be number one. That's your prediction. Okay. So I'm saying is we are in a double jeopardy because on one hand we are getting an influx of a lot of negativity from the environment. On the second side, our own internal resources, we are being depleted by these external factors as well as internally we lack awareness and we are not putting in enough effort to build ourselves, fortify ourselves from within. So it's like external is eating you up. Inside also, the internal system is getting corroded and rusted. So, you know, you can imagine the individuals are crumbling very fast. The mental apparatus is breaking down. That's what depression is all about. Your mind is breaking up. You know, you think it's easier to commit suicide than to go and talk to somebody and believe that people are out there who care for you, who will listen to you and help you. It just shows a pathetic state of society that we are living in. And we are not talking about adults committing suicide. We are talking about really young school children committing suicide. So it's very, very... I mean, people like us who work in the field of mental health, especially for us, we really feel very sad when we read these things. Again, the India has always been a leader in everything. So you can see the maximum number of things I have put is for India. Scam nation, land of corruption, inflation, slums and shanties, potholes and pollution. Number one. No, I think we should be very realistic about it, much as all of us are Indians and we love our country and all that. But it's also time to take a very realistic look at what India and Indians are all about. I mean, we have a lot of good things and good things to rest on, but there's a lot that's going wrong with our country. And I think every day greater and greater magnitude is staring us in the face. So we have to look at it and we have to do something about it. So seeing that this is happening on a global scale and at a very large scale in India, external conflicts and disharmony, so what are we doing and how should we do something? I'm going to quickly run through this whole presentation because I've put my points across, but the whole idea, main discussion we'll do is after we've finished with this. Yeah? Okay, so two questions to ask is, how does one live in harmony with a conflict-ridden world? I mean, what is it that you should do? And the other question is, how do you live in harmony with your own self? Because every person, one is your relationship with your own self. The other is your relationship with the outer world. Yeah, you all have a relationship with your own self. Yeah, we do, yeah. Acceptance is your answer. Okay. Yeah, acceptance is of course. Sorry? You live through life and you are sane. You're saying you've lived and you're sane. Yeah, if you've lived and you're sane, then you're sorted. That means you're in harmony. So you're saying we have destroyed nature. Because, you know, I remember distinctly the reading in my textbooks in school and all that about conservation and, you know, being very concerned about my environment and everything that can go wrong. And I never imagined that within a few years, there's going to be such a total change, degradation, that, you know, I'm going to live to see. I never imagined in my lifespan I'm going to live to see extinction of tigers or, you know, forests totally disappearing. And all the kind of natural things that are going wrong. So as you rightly said, whatever you do, your actions rebound back on you. Right. All of you are with him when he's saying that? One of the factors, and the other factors should also come from all of you. Okay. Right. Let us understand our inner being relationship with your own self and then move to the relationship with the world. Exactly. Right. Every day is a challenge and you keep... Every one of you is overcoming challenges on a day-to-day basis. Yeah. Yeah. Sorry? Yeah. Right. So what is the point that you're trying to make? Right. Yeah, so when we're talking about harmony, the very first quote that I had displayed at Mahatma Gandhi, we're not talking about harmony as absence of conflict. We're talking about dealing with whatever stuff that you have to deal with, whatever challenges that you have to deal with. Because there are certain type of people, especially we see certain type of people who are mentally disturbed. They are not the people who are dealing with their day-to-day challenges, you know. So their way of being dealing with is not dealing because they have got mental impairments. So that's not living in harmony. Or many people, you know, they will have a lot of things to deal with, responsibilities to deal with. But they will switch it off. You know, if you just switch on the TV and switch off the world, that is not the end of it. Or if you just, you're dunking yourself with alcohol, that's not the end of it. But I'm saying mental health is a totally different ball game and the discussion of it can just go on and on. And the reason I'm saying the first point only, I've talked about harmony in your inner being, remaining sane. Because sanity is a very debatable issue. There are so many things which are not right with our society. These are issues of mental health. But because the numbers are very large and we see these people walking all around in society scot-free, that's why it's considered that these are normal part of the population. But these are disturbed people who really need treatment. But we are not very vigilant, we are not very aware, especially in our country where there is so much stuff going on in the name of spirituality, religion. Mental health needs are not recognized. For a very long time, Indians, we have not believed that we have any mental health issues. We think these are all Western, you know, things. And we think we are extremely superior and very spiritual beings and very simple and somewhere high up there. But I have been myself attending spiritual classes, and some of the people, you need to be, I'm saying if you're trained, then you can see it. So I'm saying some of the people that I have met in spiritual classes are extremely mentally disturbed people. They're very confused people. A confused mind cannot make sense of life and religion and everything else. Because first you have to make sense of your own self. If you're not aware of your own self and whatever your life is all about, then you can't make sense of the afterlife. There should be. Very good. I endorse this thought. Just as you have a gym for physical health, you should have mental health gymnasiums, which is what we counselors try to do. But whenever we try to propagate the idea of mental health, it's always that we are trying to set up our own shop or sell ourselves. Right. That's right. 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 So as you're saying, the services are increasing, so is the population, or so is that our desires are also increasing. So somewhere there, the balance is just not coming. Yeah. I mean, in our country also, I'm saying again, adding to one of the list of woes that I have, whatever I've been reading from the papers, is about, you know, we have so much of inflation about basic necessities, food prices, everything. And on the other hand, we have so much of food, grains especially, which is going waste. They're just lying and rotting in the granaries. So somewhere, you know, something is really not right. And I think we ourselves are responsible for it. The problem is that we are responsible because somewhere we have not taken the onus upon us to rule the country. We are a democratic country. All of us want the dirty jobs to be done by somebody else. We want somebody, we don't mind giving certain part of our income, paying our taxes or giving money, but we want somebody to do the dirty work. Because policemen out there, they have a very tough life. Much as they may be corrupt or whatever they are doing, their life is very tough. Day in and day out, they are dealing with criminals and government, which are equally corrupt criminals. The government bodies themselves, you know, you're dealing with a different lots of Indian masses. Many are illiterate and uncouth and all kinds of people. It's not easy for them. So we don't want to do the dirty job. We want them to do it. When they are doing the work for us, they are taking big cuts out of it. So somewhere we are responsible for it. Anyway, sanity, our own sanity. When we are talking about sanity, different people may have different ideas about what you consider sane. Yeah? What I would talk about being mentally sane means being self-aware, being productive, means, you know, your ability to get a decent education, to be able to make yourself useful to society, to carry on with some of the responsibilities that you've undertaken, being a single person or being a member of a family. These are things which I would say make you a sane person. When you have neither too complex a person, neither inferior nor superior complex, you know, reasonable ability to get along with others, these are indicators of being sane. Okay. Aligning your living with your values. Very often there's conflict in our inner being because we believe in something, but our actions are contrary.